Hi, Cindy here with Create Your Own Luck and Love. Welcome. Today we are talking about the holiday season as it is the holiday season right now. So if you're in America, you're about ready to have Thanksgiving this week. And I know you Canadians already have it, but at any rate, I am excited to talk to you guys about how to attract a quality man by Christmas. So often, dating and relating can feel awkward this time of year. And what's even more challenging is all the questions like, are you still single? Why are you still single? You're such a great catch. What's wrong? Is there something wrong with you? Right? And all of these conversations come up, and they may be going on in your head more so than they're actually going on around you. I was actually reading something on Instagram today that really inspired me. It was a post by Sarah Blakely, and she was talking about, and if you don't know who Sarah Blakely is, I highly recommend following her. She is the CEO and founder of Spanx, ladies, the undergarments that many of us love. So what she was sharing today was about how her entrepreneurial journey actually kept her alone a lot. You know, she was eating dinners out by herself and doing things alone a lot in her 20s and 30s, and met her husband a little bit later. Now they have 4 kids. So I'm sharing this with you because most people at the end of the day truly want a loving, committed relationship. So unless there's, you know, sociopathic tendencies or narcissistic tendencies or those kinds of things, and you find that you're attracting unavailable people over and over again, I'm going to support you in shifting that. I actually have a Black Friday special coming up that's going to support you in literally breaking through your love life. More on that later. I will definitely show you guys the link to that later. But here are 3 things that can support you in dating during the holiday season, because it doesn't need to be awkward. It can be fun, and you can actually attract high quality men. So how do you do that? 1, let go of your expectations. Let go of everything. Get really, really clear on your vision. So the vision thing is first. What do you want? Why? What is really, really important to you in this area of your life? And are you afraid to declare that? Are you afraid to say, gosh, I really want a loving, committed relationship that leads towards marriage? Or I really, you know, whatever it is you desire in your life, are you afraid to say that for fear that you're going to push someone away? Well, the law of attraction states that you will actually push love away by saying that to yourself or out loud to the universe. That is not needy, by the way. So here's the deal. Go and date and have fun, because there's so many great activities to do during this time of year. I'm going to share a quick story with you. So a client of mine, a couple years back, she had literally been ghosted right before Thanksgiving from a boyfriend that she'd been with nearly a year. I've talked about her before, but I want to share this because it's my favorite story to share this time of year when it comes to attracting lasting love. So she reached out to me, and she was just in this place of, you know, obviously feeling abandoned and discouraged. And yet she had a bigger vision on wanting to attract a really amazing partner into her life, lasting love. So we worked on what her vision was, and I energetically supported her moving forward. And literally, she was having a blast. She was, you know, on Tinder. She was on dating apps. She was, you know, connecting, conversating, you know, meeting people, going to holiday parties, and really embracing her life. She was having a good time. She was letting go of expectations. And then she met this gentleman that, you know, they went on their first meeting. I call your first date meet and greet, a couple weeks before Christmas. And they had a nice time. She actually called me afterwards and she said, you know, I had a really great time. He's really interesting. I don't know. I could definitely see being friends with him. I don't know if it's going to go anywhere. So they ended up having their second date during on Christmas Day, actually. It's a super cute story. But I'll save you the details. Part of the reason why she said, you know, I don't know, because she really didn't know if he liked her in that aspect. So but here's the deal. They ended up having a great connective conversation. They shared with each other what their visions really were and ultimately in relationship in life, which were pretty similar. Obviously not exactly the same, but similar. Here's a couple things. She wanted to meet somebody who didn't have kids because she didn't have kids. And this man has two kids. So, and he wanted, I don't know, it was something else that he didn't want, but she is that. So they ended up meeting, they ended up connecting. Now they're literally a blended family. And it's, she can't imagine life being different. Why am I sharing this with you? Because you guys expect the unexpected. I truly believe in miracles at any time of the year. And this is the time where I see miracles all the time. So be so clear in your vision and literally just have fun. Allow magic to come into your life. Allow, you know, there's so many great things to do, from going to, you know, see really cool Christmas lights. There's always festive events, holiday parties. And when you get those awkward conversations like, you know, why are you still single? And instead of your eyes going wide and feeling bad about yourself, saying, you know what? That's a really good question. Do you have any great people to set me up with? Stay in your power and, you know, feel that fear, feel that natural reaction that you might feel, and move forward anyways. Because, and a lot of times we all have blind spots. That's part of the reason why I set up a really amazing Black Friday special for you guys to really dive in and get some amazing breakthrough mindset coaching. Expect the unexpected and do what you're resisting. So if you're resisting going online, do that. Jump into it. Get on Bumble. Get on Hinge. Just go. Meet people. And know what your vision is. Know that if you want a loving, committed relationship, awesome. Look at what you've had in the past and look at what you want and what you want differently, instead of looking at nothing's worked out, I can't trust men, I can't trust anyone. Look at, there are plenty of really amazing men that I can trust, because I can trust myself, I can trust my friends, I can trust my tribe. I know there's a great partnership for me. So through that, there's an opportunity, right? And anything that's holding you back, if you have your mind on an ex, anything that gets to be unhooked, look at your vision and keep moving forward instead of staying frozen in time and putting it on the back burner. Because that client of mine that I shared with you about, whom she had, you know, she had every reason why she should put this area of her life on hold, and she was going to until, oh, I'll just make love a priority the next year. I have some business goals. I have, you know, she had a hurt ankle at the time. There's all kinds of things. I'm really, really busy. Make it a priority if it's in your vision, and carve out a little bit of time, and you'll be amazed at how supported and supportive it'll be when you actually receive an amazing relationship. And don't settle. Have that vision and have fun with it. Date in the process. Meet really fun, interesting people and not be attached to what it looks like. So oftentimes we're attached to how it should look, how this date should turn out, how he should show up, should, rather than getting support on, you know, what the possibilities are. What, you know, think about something in your life that's turned out really amazing, but showed up in a way that you would have never expected. So I'm curious, who's ready to attract lasting love now? Let me know. Just put yes, I'm ready in the comment box, and you get to change your perspective, and I'm here to support you around that right here, right now. Sending so much love. I hope you have an amazing day. So, three things, what you get to do. What you resist persists. So step through that. Feel the fear of moving forward and do it anyways. Momentum is momentum. Forward momentum is something that will support you. The universe will see it, and you'll start receiving results in what you desire. If you're focusing on lack, you're going to continue to get lack. Okay, so do that. And have fun. Let go of expectations and expect miracles because they're waiting for you. Lots of love. Have an amazing day. Bye.